YouTube, it's DJ RuDe again. This time I'm with a brand new light that I received. I ordered this by mail. I got it a few weeks ago, and I actually had already done a video on it, but I hadn't, you know, shot some actual footage of the unit in action because I was having problems with the focus on the very camera that I'm using right now. But I used some of my ingenuity, took it apart, and got it working right. But that's another story. So we're going to focus today on the MicroStar made by American DJ. It is basically a small version of the Galaxian, but it has a different effect. Basically, it's got like a star pattern, like a green star pattern, and then the red dots are similar to that of the Galaxian. It comes with a remote control, and like I said, it's very similar to the Galaxian Mini or Micro. But it has a slightly different feature. This is what it looks like in the box when you get it, other than, of course, you see the C-clamp in here. I put that in there for my own personal use for gigs. But this is it. And the thing I like about this bad boy is the fact that you can pick it up and you can take it and you can, well, no, okay, maybe you can't put it in your pocket here, but you can put it in your pocket, right? Well, you like my mismatched clothes? You know, it's what, 1 o'clock in the morning? I'm wearing plaid shorts and a plaid shirt, but, you know, oh well. Anyways, it's small, it's light, it can be put in your pocket, you can scare the hell out of somebody with it, you know, if you have like a battery pack or something. No, anyways, so let's just get a little close up here of what it looks like here. This right here is where the red diode is and the green diode. It's got a dual yoke so that you don't have to have it mounted. You can actually just set it on a table and aim it any direction you like. On the back here, you can see it's got a cooling fan, your switch, your DC 12 volt input. So you could actually use like a battery pack for it. Here's the antenna. And then here's your sound activation. And you can, you have the microphone as well. And then, you know, your adjustment for slow and fast. This is your variable dial here. So as you can see, it's a very nice light. It's very lightweight. It can be mounted any such way. I prefer to mount it on the top of my speakers. Basically, I put the C-clamp that I showed you in there, and I mount it to the top of my speakers, aiming this way like this, and I can put it in any direction that I wish. So what we're gonna do is, take the rest of the stuff out of the box so you can kind of get an idea of what it comes with. Here is the handheld remote. Got a antenna that pulls out, and you've got auto sound mode A, B button's blackout, C is color, and the D is the direction of the gobo, basically of the patterns. So you can change it from going one way to the other way. And here is the power pack, 12 volt power pack. And like I said, I use an American DJ C clamp with it, that it actually fits nicely underneath the package. And I'm able to keep it in the box and take it with me to my gigs. So, okay, so we take the washer first, and we put it under here. Here's the bolt. Put it through like such, and take your clamp and screw it on here. So those of you who are familiar with the American DJ C clamp, you can see just how it contrasts with this light, with the MicroStar. You can see that it's a very small unit, but don't let the size fool you. This thing puts out quite an array, as we'll see in just a few minutes. So what I do is I tighten this up. It takes an Allen key or an Allen wrench, depending on what part of the country or what part of the world you're at in. You tighten it here, but anyway, what I do is I mount it to the speaker pole, just like this, up kind of high. It doesn't have to rest on anything, it's very lightweight, and then I just aim it whichever direction. So it actually puts out almost as much as the Galaxian itself does, but this is, you know, just, it's just amazing how small it is and what it can do. The other cool thing that I wanted to mention is the fact that since it's double yoked, obviously you can use it to mount on a table. So as, you know, I'm showing you here, to aim it in any direction you want by just adjusting, you know, either one of the legs. But the other cool thing is that, you know, since there is a mounting hole on both sides, as you can see, I've got the C-clamp mounted directly on the larger of the two. This can be brought all the way around this way, and another one, like say the Micro Gobo or the Micro Galaxian, can be mounted on below it. Or you can mount three of them together, the Micro Galaxian, the Micro Gobo, and the Micro Star. So that would be an interesting combination to have all three of these mounted together. And the cool thing is that you can twist them, you know, slightly, like this way and the other one that way and this one straight ahead. You kind of get the idea of what I'm trying to say? I think that that would be a really good idea. I wish I had two more of these, each one a different one, to do that with. I think that would make a really cool effect. So just imagine what I'm saying. One down here mounted this way, while the one you're looking at is mounted straight ahead. And then the one down here mounted that way slightly. So it would actually fill up a much larger space. You know, you could actually fill up like 180 degrees with, you know, different various shapes, designs, and patterns, of course. So anyway, that's just something to think about. That's one of the other cool things about the yoke. Nice idea, I thought. American DJ, good idea. So let's go ahead and see this bad boy in action in the dark, and then I'll put a little bit of footage from my last gig that I used it on. By the way, I want to make a note that I had done a video on this earlier, and I had a problem with my camera, as I said. Brian Red has actually a very, very nice video of the same light that he got out over this last weekend, and I'm going to attach it as a video response to his video. Thank you, Brian, for inviting me to do that. So take a look at his video as well if you haven't already seen it. Very nice. I especially like how he took it outside in the fog over there in Milwaukee, and it just really had an eerie effect. It almost looked like, you know, he was in a, it looked like a haunted house, from, you know, the back of a haunted house. Anyway, so let's go ahead and see this bad boy in action. DJ RuDe. Fills up the whole area of the dining room. So right here, it's mounted on the stairwell, and you can see that I'm aiming it into the kitchen, kind of like Brian Red did. I didn't mean to steal his idea, but this is really the only open space in the house. Just me and another single person live here, so there's not a lot in the house. So you kind of get to have an idea of what it's like. So let me go ahead and shut off the lights. As you can see, it puts on a pretty dazzling array. Right now, I just have it on, it's not on sound active mode, it's just going, it's just going off. It's going off. Now it covers this whole area, there it is. As you can see, kind of just the silhouette of it right there. And it's filling up the whole dining room. I mean, it really covers a huge area for such a little tiny light. And the thing I like about it is a solid metal construction. It's not made of plastic, you know, it's made of aluminum all the way around. There's nothing plastic on the unit at all. So it's really super durable. If you dropped it, it would probably survive the drop. So let's go ahead and mess around with the switches a little bit.
Well, this is pushing button number A.
Okay.
This just makes it auto and sound activated. A. So if you just want it to go constantly, whether there's music or not, you just hit the A button with their wireless remote. Okay, the B button. The B button just shuts it off completely, as you can see. Okay, so I'll turn it back on, and there you go. There's this, the green star pattern, and then the reds kick back in. C is for color. Okay, so there's all your red pinpoints just moving around, similar to the Galaxian. Hit it again, and then you have your green star pattern. And D is the direction. So you can see that it rotates the opposite direction. Hit it again, and it goes the other way. Okay, so now we'll hit the C button for color. We'll put both colors back in, and we'll change the direction by hitting the D button again. Hit it again, hit it again, hit it again. So it's very nice, although I find myself not using the remote. I just basically put it in sound active mode. So there you have it. That's on the inside. So let's go ahead and take it outside and get an idea of what it does out by the pool. Okay, so we're outside by the pool, and I don't have the pool light on because we don't want to disturb the effects that the light has in the great outdoors. And similarly, we have it mounted on hot iron, painted white just like the stairwell. And kind of close up, it's pretty dark. Let's go ahead and hit the night vision real quick. There we go, so you can see where it's mounted and how it looks where it's at. And you can see the effects that it has in the back. So let's go ahead and turn the night vision back off. And let's turn off the lights. Let's not trip over and break our necks. So this is what we have right here. This is covering the whole backyard. And I don't know if you can see the pool. Let's see if the night vision has anything to do with that. And there's the edge of the pool. But it's pretty much covering the entire backyard. At least a 90 degree swath of the backyard. That's why I was saying stacking three of them together like that on the yoke would be a really cool idea, and I think it would just be an awesome display. So let's put the fog on. See, here in Southern California, we don't quite get the fog that Mr. Brian Redd does out there in Milwaukee, so we have to take it. Right now it's about 2 o'clock in the morning here in Riverside, California, which is about 70 miles outside of Los Angeles, 80 miles maybe, and it's probably a balmy 72 degrees. As we all know, fog doesn't look too hot outdoors, but you get the idea of the beauty of it. The fog machine, I think this thing, I bought it at Walmart for Halloween about 10 years ago. And it's lasted better than any of my high quality, high dollar fog machines, like my Omni system that I bought. A pyro fog that lasted 3 gigs and cost me $500. Oh, there we go. See my focus problem? Still not completely gone away, but I did fix it somewhat. So anyway, you can kind of get an idea of what it does. Quite an awesome light for what it is. So there you have it, the American DJ MicroStar. $99 at your local retailer, or it can be ordered online. Check it out at AmericanDJ.com. This is DJ Rude, and I'm glad you were able to check out the video. Make sure you check out Brian Redd's video of the same light, so you kind of get more of an idea of what it does in real fog situations. Okay, everybody, take care. Look out for my next video on the ComScan LED. This is DJ Rude. Peace.